Welcome to BioSpectrum's News Bulletin. Headlines for today are: Australian researchers design nanoparticles for drug delivery. US team develops non-invasive test for ovarian cancer. New variant of dengue virus identified. Scientists connect blood pressure pills with wound healing. Moving on to the main news now. Australian researchers design nanoparticles for drug delivery. A group of researchers at the University of New South Wales in Australia have developed a way to control the shape of polymer molecules so that they self-assemble into non-spherical nanoparticles, which could improve the delivery of toxic drugs to tumors. The researchers have preliminary evidence that these more natural-shaped plastic nanoparticles enter tumor cells more easily than the spherical ones. The team's novel chemical design is to add a non-water soluble perylene polymer group to the membrane of the polymer zone that are hollow structures. The shape and size of the polymer zone can then be adjusted by changing the amount of water in the solvent. The team used cryogenic transmission electron microscopy, the technique for which the 2017 Nobel Prize in Chemistry was awarded, to determine how the polymer molecules were packed together in solution. US team develops non-invasive tests for ovarian cancer. Investigators from Brigham and Women's Hospital and Dana-Farber Cancer Institute in the US are leveraging the power of artificial intelligence to develop a new technique to detect ovarian cancer early and accurately. The team has identified a network of circulating microRNAs, small non-coding pieces of genetic material, that are associated with risk of ovarian cancer and can be detected from a blood sample. The team has sought out a tool that would be more sensitive and specific in detecting true cases of early stage cancer. To move the diagnostic tool out of the lab and into the clinic, the research team will need to verify how the microRNA signature changes over time as risk of ovarian cancer increases. To do so, they will need to use prospectively collected longitudinal samples following women over time. They are particularly interested in determining if the tool will be useful for women at high risk of ovarian cancer as well as the general population. New variant of dengue virus identified. Scientists at the National Institute of Virology in Pune have found a genetic variant of the existing dengue virus in Tamil Nadu. According to the World Health Organization, the dengue virus comprises four distinct serotypes, namely 1, 2, 3, and 4. Distinct genotypes, that is genetic structures, have been identified within each of these serotypes. During this study, the scientists found that the Asian genotype of serotype 1 had entered India from Singapore. The Asian genotype was responsible for epidemics in Singapore during 2005 and in Sri Lanka during 2009. This identification of the Asian variant requires further study to understand its role in the recurrent dengue outbreaks in the country, and it is too early to say the Asian genotype has replaced the African American genotype. Scientists connect blood pressure pills with wound healing. An international team of researchers led by Johns Hopkins has shown that a topical gel made from a class of common blood pressure pills that block inflammation pathways speeds the healing of chronic skin wounds in mice and pigs. Chronic wounds are identified as skin injuries that fail to heal in a timely manner and increase the risk of infection and tissue breakdown. The researchers experimented with gel formulation of angiotensin II receptor antagonists or blockers, a long-standing class of drugs that includes losartan and valsartan prescribed to treat hypertension. The drugs block the renin-angiotensin system and increase wound blood flow, and the goal was to apply the gels directly to the wounds, increasing wound tissue level of the drugs that promote faster healing. The results showed that valsartan was more effective in accelerating wound healing than losartan, without any significant difference in healing time between valsartan doses. Thank you.